Hey everybody, I wanted to walk through the geographic analysis report or the location report in Google Analytics today. I've come across some projects where we've been looking at things from like a regional perspective or from like a city to city perspective, and we've been doing some analysis that way, and that got me thinking about this report, which is pretty useful for a few use cases. So if you've been wondering how to do some geographic analysis, or if you're geo-targeting campaigns and you want to see how they're performing, this is a great place to start. So essentially, like, where is the report? Let's go find it. If you click under the audience tab on the left-hand side of Google Analytics, and again, this is the Google Analytics demo account. If you just Google that or click the link in the description, I'll provide that to you. You can get free access, and this is all dummy data. This is not my website. You'll be looking at the same thing if you look at these dates, December 28, 2019 to January 26, 2020. So you click on the audience tab on the left, then the geo dropdown, and then you click location, and you'll be provided to the or brought to the same page that I'm looking at now. And so what are we looking at? Well, we're really looking at like a visual representation of the dimensions, which are right now the countries. And the metrics, which right now are users, I believe. Yeah, users. So if you mouse over any of these countries, you can see in the state range how many users came to the site from that country. And it's a pretty practical number from Google standpoint. Like, it's pretty accurate in what I've seen. I wouldn't assume that it's more than like 1 to 5% off. So pretty accurate, especially at the continent level or the country level. You know, if you want to drill down, you can either come down here and you can say like, okay, I want to find out the breakdown of people in the United States. Click on that and it will show the next closest sub-region or sub-grouping that is available. For the US, that's obviously states. And then if you click down further from a region, you can see the city. And what I've noticed sometimes is that, and you can see in this map that there are some big dots close to some little dots. And really what that means is like those visits are concentrated, and the more people in that small concentrated area, the bigger it gets. So that's why there's some overlap. But you will notice too, this does depend on like where your internet service provider is kind of like routing your traffic. I've been in various parts of Tampa, Florida, and been shown to be in other parts of Tampa, Florida. And that's just natural, it happens. So. So that's how you drill down. The other way that you can drill down is actually, we'll go back to the overview here, is instead of clicking down here, you can click on any one of these countries. So we clicked on the US, let's click on it again, and we can see this visual representation followed by this like colorful scale with density, right? So it looks like we have a ton of users in California, and then maybe some less in these Midwest states. You know, Nebraska is obviously, Wyoming is the lightest. And also the smallest amount. So you can click through and drill down. You know, we can look at Florida, we can drill down to the cities. And if you mouse over these, you can see that you can mouse over even deeper, right? So that's how you drill down. If you want to export these reports, I've gone over this in a couple different ways, but you can export to Google Sheets or to an Excel file or to a CSV and take a look at that as well. But really, the last thing I wanted to answer is, how do you use this, or what is it used for? And there's a few different ways. You know, if you're running through like a programmatic ad platform, or if you're launching a new platform, such as Facebook or maybe Google Display, a lot of times those platforms hide the targeting a little bit from you. So if you're not experienced in it, then you might actually be advertising to people beyond the country or the area that you're targeting. And there are many ways that comes up, and I won't go into depth into those. Feel free to email me if you do have questions or post a comment. But this is a great way to say like, okay, well, if we know that the traffic is coming through the specific source and we select that, and then we look at the traffic that's actually showing up and it says, okay, you know, we have traffic from Google, but that's coming from Gainesville. We weren't targeting that region. We weren't targeting Boca Raton, all these other places in Florida outside of Tampa. Then we know that the traffic is a little bogus and we need to tighten up our targeting. And so sometimes you'll need to talk to your campaign manager. Sometimes you can do that internally. Other than that, you can look at transaction analysis. So you can see on the right-hand side here, we have e-commerce conversions showing up. And I'll zoom out a little bit so we can take a good look. But if we want to know where transactions are coming from, or verify where these people are coming from, sometimes your systems are a little funky and you don't get all of that information. We can see that people are in the US and we have a couple international customers. This is a great way to drill down and do that. And especially if you're working in some sort of like hybrid or high revenue transaction, you'll have sales team members working in specific regions. So you might look at the United States and say like, hey, we're spending a lot of money in, Texas, New York, and California. Is that paying off by region? And you might find out that, you know, maybe there's another regional provider and a competitor in that area and it's not working. So it's a great way to look at and compare the revenue and the transaction data. The last thing is regional performance of individual campaigns, which I kind of touched on. A lot of times what you'll do is you'll roll your ad campaign out to several people. And those people will be based either in different cities in the same state, or maybe in different states, or maybe in just big metros. You know, a lot of people like to advertise to people in New York and San Francisco and Chicago, especially enterprise level tools, because that's where the big companies are. And so what you can do is you can really look at the revenue you're driving and the transactions you're driving, and kind of loop in like this like lifetime value of a client or a customer, and figure out if the amount you're spending is worth it, you know? And so you can basically compare the cost to the revenue and get your net profit at a really basic level. So yeah, that's how I'd recommend using it. This is a very easy report. It's not something that you need to check in all the time unless you're doing those very specific things. But sometimes when you're digging down to a problem, do I have ad fraud? Are my campaigns performing? Are our sales reps working in these new regions, or do we need to change our sales strategy? These are the kinds of questions that can you can help like unveil part of the pie and answer those big questions with little bits of data. So if you have any questions, let me know. I'm happy for me and my floral print painting behind me to answer those questions, and I hope you enjoyed this.